สวัสดีค่ะเพื่อนๆ Hello everyone. Today I got this beautiful piece of beef to cook something with you. I think today we will cook a beef Wellington. So the origin of this dish is to celebrate the first Duke of Wellington that won the Battle of Waterloo in 1815. And also it's because of before he became the Prime Minister of Britain, he defeated Napoleon as well. So this dish is dedicated to him. Yay!
Yeah!
Right. Let's get serious. Let's get straight to what we're going to do today. With beef Wellington, we got this beautiful cut of a fillet of beef. When you go to buy the fillet of beef from the butcher, just ask for the DI of the fillet or chateaubriand, or another word, I will come to it. No, another word, filet mignon. Okay, first of all, we just going to season it with salt and pepper. Well, I'll just put pepper on first. I use Himalayan salt. Well, any rough salt would do. All over. And then I'm just going to let it sit for a little while we prepare the duxelle. Now the next step, we're going to do the duxelle. Again. The duxelle is the paste that we're going to cover over the fillet of beef before we wrap it with the Parma ham and the pastry to make it into the log shape and to make it into the beef Wellington. So what we need are mushroom. You can use all kind of mushroom, mix it together. But today I'm going to use the chestnut mushroom. And because of like such a big piece of beef, so I thought that I will have to use about 900 to a kilogram of mushroom to do the paste. So apart from mushroom, you will need onions, shallot, and garlic. And then we're just going to finely chop the mushroom and onions together. And then we're going to fry it. Okay? Okay, we got the mushroom rubbery chopped here, and then I'm just going to pass through the machine along with onions and garlic. Alright, mushroom in. Or if you're not lazy like me, just continue chopping it by hand. Put some garlic in. I use about 4-5 cloves of garlic. Put a bit of shallot in as well. Or if you don't have shallot, just use onion. I use 1 kilogram of mushroom, and I use 3 large onion and 2 shallot. Once we got the mushroom paste, we now going to cook it. Follow me. What we will need to do with this mushroom is to fry it off, and I will want to add a little bit of the whiskey to make it taste even better. But what we have to be like sort of aware of, we need this paste
to be quite dry once it cooks. And then we will also apply it with the pastry and the serrano ham and wrap our beef fillet.
Okay.
Just need to make sure that the liquid is all dry up when we do this. And now we're going to let it cool down after we cook like this. Whew. Now it's time to sear our beef. We want to sear the beef all the side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, I don't know what, you can't count. So all around, including this bit and that bit as well. And garlic in as well with the oil, so no nice. Right. It is hell. Right. Here you are, chateaubriand, ready for you. Oops, we're not doing chateaubriand. We're going to do, what is it? Beef Wellington. So be patient and wait. And while it's still hot, we're going to put some mustard on as well. And beef. Okay, while we're waiting for the beef and the mushroom to cool down, we're going to prepare some juice / gravy. We need the trimming and the bone to make like sort of a stock for it. We also have the beef stock here. I have a bit of shallot. Like 4 shallots and slice them. And this is the bit that you will like. I have like a cup or two of red wine, a cup or two of port. Let's get started doing this juice. Right, we need a bit of oil in. And I'm just going to put our trimming in to flavor our juice. Bone, a bit of bone. Putting some shallot in. To put in our stock. And now our stock has become bubbling, so we're going to add our red wine and the port, and then we're just going to leave it to cook down, to reduce down
probably it will take about 40-45 minutes to an hour.
Right, now we're going to wrap our fillet steak, well, fillet of beef, and with a little twist, I'm just going to put some crepe or pancake on before we roll it, overlap it a bit. So just to make sure that it's going to cover our beef, okay? I just make sure that it will cover our beef, and that should help hold everything in and nothing leak out in when we cook later. Serrano ham. Our ham should be like this. Going to take quite a lot because our beef is so big. Right, and then we're going to put the mushroom paste all over the ham. Right, we're going to put the beef down here, I think. Roll. Pull it. Yeah? Like that. Like that, like that, like that, like that. Got our fillet wrapped in pancake with the mushroom paste to sell, and ham ready, tighten wrap in, and then we're going to put in the fridge for a few hours. So once the juice been reduced down, we just need to strain it out, get all the bits and like the bone and the trimming out. And you will be left with this beautiful, beautiful juice. So I'll save it for later before we serve. I'm just going to add with a few knob of butter. What I forgot to mention is when I was waiting for the juice to be reduced, I had pre-prepared some vegetable as well. That will be our side dish with carrots. Kale and green bean, and I just put in the ice water so it keep the color fresh. And in the oven right now, I got beetroot, so I'm roasted the beetroot as well. This baked beetroot, I think it's done. So when it cool down a bit, I'm just going to peel the skin off, and that should be ready to serve. And next we will roll out the pastry. It's because of my beef Wellington is so big, so I will need to roll it out to the side of this board, I think. Yeah. Okay, let me just egg wash the pastry there. So after a few hours in the fridge, cut this side bit off a bit. Right, and then I'm just going to score the pastry so it look a little bit pretty with the back of the knife. Then we're going to put this in the oven, the preheated oven at 200 degrees Celsius for about 25 to 35 minutes. But you just need to check the temperature. I'm going to do a little ladybird. Stick through so we can put the tape. So you can use olive or you can use blueberry, something black. We got the our ladybird. Put them on my garden. Got the beetroot branch, so I'm going to add the color on. I'll check this out. Our attempt to make the Wonderland. Oh, and now it's cooked. I think after being in the oven 200 degrees for about, because it's such a big piece, so we take about 40 minutes today. Normally, smaller piece is about 25, 30 to 35 minutes.